and almost drowned. He kissed the ground, but his guts were churned up in this town where down was up and up was down. So the boy from down under flipped right around. Ned did a cartwheel and stopped halfway, and he walked on his palms from that day. But city folk treated Ned like a freak.
That hand walking one-headed yeti can't speak.
One night walking home, Ned was quite shocked. He saw a b-boy spinning on the sidewalk. He couldn't stop, wouldn't stop, staring at those limbs, spinning like a wooden top, sweeter than a pudding pop. Ned was home at last, and every night he'd watch him dance through the glass of the club, and he'd wait there in line for his chance. But the bouncer said, "Freak, you can't dance!" It was a miracle we're hearing. The creatures of the evening came creeping to the clearing to see this little man nugget, soon to be immortalized in poetry, just like the man from Nantucket. But as the little babe was grown, they gave him their home and raised him as their own. He roamed and trapezed from the tallest trees. He got his steez from the wallabies. They all loved him. But the Tasmanian devils loved little Neddy more than all of them. They taught him how to spin like a fan, till Ned spun himself into a fine young man. But one day, like a sick disease, loggers crept in and chopped the eucalyptus trees. They smushed the cuddly forest creatures, and they turned him into body wash and sneakers. But Ned escaped and yelled angrily, "Then you abandoned me! You killed my family! But goddammit, I can't use your pity!" And he snuck onto a ship bound for New York City!
Yeah.